Hey guys, my name is Wes, and you're watching Wes Equals TV, and today I'm reviewing Dirty Grandpa. Dirty Grandpa is a 2016 comedy starring Robert De Niro and Zac Efron, and I gotta say, right now, it's my favorite movie of 2016. Now, it's only beating out Ride Along 2 in the Forest, but it doesn't really matter whoever you're playing against as long as you're number one, right? And right now, it is. The reason I say that is because this movie is really funny. A lot of times when you watch a comedy, a lot of the huge, big jokes were in the trailer, and you laugh at those, so you see them already there, but you've already seen them, and that's basically all the funny moments. This is not one of those films. I'm constantly telling people, when I watch a comedy, what I want to see is a lot of jokes I can chuckle throughout the film. Just, ha, that's funny, keep me interested. And then, the big jokes that have me tell my friends and family about it later on. And this movie succeeded in both those things. I found myself really enjoying a lot of the smaller humor that just kind of keeps the movie going along, kept me having fun, kept me smiling. But I also found myself laughing really loud and a lot of the stupider jokes, the big jokes they want you to laugh at. This is a movie that's really built on being like a dirty humor, insulting the other characters in the movie, just stuff like that. I grew up with a bunch of brothers. That's my kind of humor. I think that's just hilarious, and I thought that this movie was hilarious. Now, I also think the acting was really good in this movie. Robert De Niro went through a time period where he was just mailing it in to get the paycheck. And there's a small smidge when you see this trailer, you're going, is that what he's going to do in this movie? I don't know. And then you see the Red Bad trailer, you're saying, maybe not. I actually think this is one of those situations where you put almost any other actor in this movie, in that role, doesn't work nearly as well. I bought that character. I think that could be Robert De Niro in real life. That if he wasn't this huge celebrity, that's who he would have been. So that's a huge addition to this film. It's just a great plus. Zac Efron is also really good in this movie. A lot of people, I hear all the time, he's not a good actor. I disagree with that. There are plenty of films that he's been in that he's just fantastic in. But he gets overshadowed by himself. He's always taking off his clothes, and that's all anybody talks about. I get it for girls. That guy is attractive. That is one, like, grade A piece of guy right there. I understand it. Not my thing, but hey, that's what brings in the bucks from the female demographic, so they do it. But it really overshadows his actual talent, and he's really good in this movie, so try to look beyond just that. Aubrey Plaza is fan-freaking-tastic in this movie. Every time she's on the screen, she's making me laugh. Her chemistry with Robert De Niro was almost too good. It's weird, because their flirting back and forth was hilarious, and it worked perfectly for this film. Also, the guy who plays Rafi in The League, I can't remember his name. Most of the time, I've checked it before, had it, then I forget it. It's a longer last name. But he's hilarious. He's playing the same guy he plays most of the time. But in a supporting role, that really works. And so I was really happy to see him. He brought a lot of humor to this film. There's also two cops in the movie that really just had a fun dynamic with the rest of the film. I thought this movie was really, really funny with the comedy. That is the most important part. There were a few negatives, though. Overall, the story outside of the basic premise isn't all that great. It's basically just a lot of different funny things going on with a small story behind it. And that's fine. But if it was a perfect film, if it was a better film, it would have had a story that really had me entertained by just the story, not just the humor. Also, the chemistry between Zac Efron's character and his romantic interest, I just really didn't buy it. I didn't see them growing it all that well, so by the end of the film, I didn't buy the ending all that well. I would have also liked to see more of Julianne Hough. I think she's a good actress. I think that she's just something I like looking at on screen, whatever. I would have liked to see more of her in this film. Overall, though, I laughed a lot in this movie. Taking all this stuff into consideration, I have to say I give this movie a 7 out of 10. It's the first movie I actually enjoyed so far of 2016. If you like just off-the-walls humor, if you enjoy dirty humor, if you want to laugh, this is the movie to go see. If you're looking for a great, rich story, check out something else because this really isn't where you want to go. But that's just my opinion, and I don't know yours. What do you think about it? Let me know in the comment section down below. While you're down there, click the like button right over here. Click subscribe right over here if you want to get more of your reviews. So you can my reviews. There's a link to another review right there. You can check that out if I click in there. And you can share me on social media. It helps me out a lot. You can follow me on Twitter at WesNichols14. Thanks for watching. My name is Wes. You're watching Wes Nichols TV. Have a great night. Bye.